Good morning, friends. It's Thursday, which means today is let's test a prototype day. I've got one down here. I haven't plugged it in. This could be a very short video for all I know. I'm just trying to work out what the pickups are. They're Chapman's own, but I actually can't remember the spec. So I've just whisked myself quickly to Andy Ferris's video where he has a review of a similar guitar.
Slightly smaller, slightly more agile and more athletic and more...
He's obviously talking about me there.
Actually, I want to say hi to Rob, because I know Rob's watching this, you know, because he's...
Hi, mate.
...up on his old mate, Andy, and I miss you, mate. Love you lots.
Love you too, bro.
In fact, what I say about your guitars.
Some absolute cockwomble put 12s on it, so I've removed those, although they were kind of fine. I might boil them and then use them on something stupid. And I've just put on a set, a fresh set... Fresh of Arcadil of 10 to 52 Paradigms, which are my chosen choice. I've just remembered what pickups these are. These are the Primordial Aunico 5 humbuckers, which is really good because I like those.
I mean, look at the body.
Thanks, man. Alrighty then. I unboxed a whole bunch of prototypes about a week and a half ago, 2 weeks ago, something like that, and fell in love with two or three of them. And I thought it would be fun to just kind of take them one at a time and talk about them and show you what it is that they're about. The situation with Chapman is that from time to time we're so busy that I don't even get involved in some of the initiated prototype stages. That's a Dave thing. Dave. I, you know, ask him to make fun things. And then from time to time, they just get stuck in a little cave somewhere. And then in this instance, a bunch of them got pulled from the cave, flown to Malta, and I've seen them for the first time. And it's really exciting. And I thought, well, I'll show you guys if you like some of them. Maybe there's legs. It's part of the collaborative thing. You know, maybe there's legs for us to bring them out at some point in the future. Not like immediate future, because it takes, you know, honestly about 2 years to bring a guitar to market. I don't know a lot about the origins of this, but I have a few clues. We made a ghost fret with a Swamp Ash top and wings for Guitar Center about 6 years ago. We did a red and black stripey one. It was a really beautiful kind of tiger looking thing, which is what Andy was demonstrating there. And I think this is one of the prototype colours that we did that potentially would have gone to Guitar Center as an exclusive, and probably they just didn't choose the colour, which is crazy because this is B-E-A-U-T-ful. It's stunning. It really is. I love the black dip. Look at that. Whoop! Just super sexy. It's a proto, so they always do weird things with prototypes. They rush them through, but they use great parts. Anyone else that makes guitars will know exactly what I'm talking about. They use great, beautiful looking woods, but then I've noticed, for example, this little elf door here, they've not cut it properly to fit the cavity, which is very, very annoying. So I'm gonna have to sand, or just remove it and get another one made. It's beautiful. Well, that plays nicely. It's got a lovely feel. It's a much thinner neck than I am currently familiar with. I think if I compare this to Skynail, here's the OG. Oh, it's much heavier. OG Chapman Ghost Fret, the first one, first prototype we ever made when I went to the factory years ago. This neck is much more substantial. Is it? It's lacquered. sometimes the lacquer... No, it's thinner. So this is a thicker neck, but it also has lacquer. I got it signed by Johnny Hyland, who's probably one of the best guitar players alive. And this is a bit flatter. It's a bit more Ibanez, if I'm honest. Interesting. Wonder if that's different from the current production model. So the other big difference I've just noticed is that obviously original OG Ghost fret was 22 frets. This is a 24 fret monster. Is that how it is on the current production? I've just pulled out the current model to check. 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 20, 21. 22 frets. Man, I'm so confused. Did Chapman ever make a ghost fret with 24 frets? Or is this prototype a 24 fret prototype? What's going on? I better phone Dave. Yeah. All right, mate, how you doing? Listen, just a super quick one. Have we ever made a ghost fret with 24 frets?
Yeah, I think we did.
The reason I'm asking is I've got a prototype. It's a green ghost fret, but it's dipped black. Swamp ash wings and top, and it's 24 frets, and I've looked online and none of the ghost frets that we sell are 24 frets. I'm wondering if that was a prototype for a 24 fret ghost fret.
I think you'll find it's 27 inch.
20, is it a baritone?
Yeah.
That explains why it had 12s on it. I was like, what's going on with the strings? Why? I'm such a bellend. I literally had no idea. I just pulled off these 12s and I was like, what am I doing? This feels really tight when I put it in standard. Now I'm looking at it, it's a baritone.
It was originally made for Leo, probably.
Oh, shit. Yes, it was. Ah, fuck. Okay. Wow. Yeah. Wicked. Thank you very much. Now I know, and I'll see you later for our chat with the factory. Wow. I feel so stupid now. Also, by the way, if you ever throw your pick and lose it, did you know that you can use the little cover where the truss rod goes as a pick, and it works really, really good. Elf Door Picks. There you go. There's a brand name for somebody. If you ever want to make a pick company, Elf Door Picks. So if you think this is a cool guitar and it's the kind of thing Chapman should consider in the future, holler at your boy. Obviously, I need to re-drill holes for these strap posts because, as you can probably see, on the new ghost frets, we've moved the position and I find this much more stable. It doesn't swing on you like this. So I'll probably do that in a minute with an electric drill. Have a great day. Take it easy. I've been Rob Chapman. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe and do all the things for the almighty AI algorithm, for it is impending upon us soon. Take it easy. Chappers out. Imagine a pick, because I can't throw one of these.